So we want to draw and find the equation for a vertical curve that connects two slopes. We'll label them G1, grade 1, grade 2. We'll mark the beginning vertical curve and the end vertical curve. So basically we want a parabola that connects both of these slopes or these grades. So we want the equation for that. Well, the general equation for a parabola is in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. Well, we're going to set the length, the horizontal length of the curve, to be equal to L. Alright, so we're going to look at the slope. So the derivative, dy dx, would be equal to 2ax plus b. Now, that represents the slope. Now, we already know the slope at 0. If I set the x-coordinate to 0 right at the beginning vertical curve, we'll call that 0h1, the elevation being the y-coordinate, 0 being the x-coordinate, and L being the x-coordinate at the end vertical curve, and h2 being the y-coordinate, or the elevation. So at 0, that sets the slope, dy dx, would be equal to g1 at 0, and that sets the 2ax, 2a times 0 would go to 0, and that would be equal to b. So we now know that g1 is equal to b, or b is equal to g1. Furthermore, at the end vertical curve, where x is equal to L, the derivative of y with respect to x at x equals L gives us g2, which is equal to 2al, x being equal to L, plus g1. So now g2 is equal to 2al plus g1. Solving this for a gives us g2 minus g1 all over 2l. So that's equal to a. So now I know what a is, and I know what b is. So I could find the slope at any point. Well, to continue that, I could find the slope at the vertex of the apex of the curve, or even the sag of a downhill curve, would be equal to 0. So the slope is equal to 0 at the top of the curve. So when I set my dy dx is equal to 0, I can solve it for x. So 2a, so 2 times g2 minus g1 over 2l times x plus b being equal to g1. I know everything but x in this equation, so we can solve. Subtract g1 from both sides, cancel the 2's, multiply by L over g2 minus g1, and that's equal to x at the vertex. But what's y at the vertex? Well, integrating back to the standard form, I don't even need to integrate because we already have the plus c, and then that puts it back. So the equation of the parabola so far is y is equal to ax, so that'd be g2 minus g1 over 2l x squared, plus bx, which is just g1 x, plus c. Now, I don't know what c is, but I do know when x is 0 what the h value is. So at the beginning vertical curve at BBC, y is equal to h1, so that's equal to, and x is equal to 0, so these would cancel. X would go to 0, and so that's equal to c. So c is now h1, or was always h1. Anyway, so my final equation for the parabola itself is going to equal g2 minus g1 over 2l times x squared plus g1x plus h1. There's my equation for the parabola. To answer the question, what's the elevation at the vertex? I can plug in the x coordinate at the vertex and find out what the y coordinate is. So let's see what that is. So y at vertex is equal to, we'll just plug in the x. So first of all, we need g2 minus g1 over 2l times x squared, which is negative g1l over g2 minus g1 squared, plus g1 times negative g1l over g2 minus g1 plus h1. Reducing some things, I have an l squared here and an l, and I have a g2 minus g1 and a g2 minus g1 squared here. So that'll break down to a single l on the top and a 2g2 minus g1 on the bottom. This term, combining, will give me a minus g1 squared l over g2 minus g1 plus h1. Well, pardon me, there's going to be a G1 right there for this one. So these two can be combined for sure. I have 1/2 of G1L over G, so that's like an 1/2 X at the vertex, and minus a full 1, so that's just a negative G1 squared there. G1 squared L over 2G2 minus G1 plus H1. So this is the Y coordinate at vertex. You can see that. So this is how I want to set up my spreadsheet to calculate the Y values or the elevations at the different station points. I want to start my station points at 0 and 25 and go every 25 feet or meters, doesn't matter. And we're going to go for a 200 feet or meter length curve. So there's some things in my example that I want to use. And also I'm going to use a 5.5% grade positive, so going upwards uphill. And on the downhill side, a 4.5% grade. In this example, we'll use any arbitrary number, about 56, 55. It's about the elevation where we are right now in feet. So this is going to be a foot example. And H2, it doesn't matter, it's not being used. But I will make that equal to the value at 200, which is going to be what the elevation is at the end vertical curve. This XV represents the X value at the vertex, so I kind of want to know what that elevation is going to be and what the X coordinate station value is at that vertex. Also, all I have to do now is type in the formula for our Y or our elevations, and that's what we got from our exercise previous. So we're going to take G2, I'm going to lock it with the F4 key, minus G1 locked. So when I scroll that down, these numbers, these cells won't change. The only ones that's going to change, the only value is going to change is the X. Those are held in place. So I'm going to divide G2 minus G1 basically by 2 times, I'm going to divide that by 2L, which, not L, but at L, and that's locked. So that's divided by 2, divided by L, or I could have put this in parentheses. Maybe that's easier to read, perhaps.
and then I could multiply those two together. Either way, so that's g2 minus g1 over 2l times x squared, right? So times this value, not locked, squared, plus g1x, so g1 locked, times the x value again, plus h1, locked. All right, that's the formula for the in a spreadsheet from the work that we did before, the math that we arrived at. So there's my first value, and then the fun part, calculate the rest. Okay, I want to know what my x value at the vertex is. So I'm going to use that formula, which we also calculated, which was negative g1. I don't really have to lock this because, well, maybe I will, just because I'm going to move this. I'm going to copy this over. So just to avoid unnecessary, times the length divided by, and we'll put in parentheses, g2 minus g1 again. And that should be the x coordinate at the vertex. Okay, so I'm gonna hold the control key and just put it down here, or I could put it in where it goes, but, and then fill that down one more. And that'll be the y coordinate, or the elevation at the vertex. So that's how I would set up my calculations to find the elevations at the different station points. Now for the fun part, we get to draw this vertical curve to show how the numbers go together and how it works. So I'm going to start a line, and I'm going to draw the two adjoining slopes. So L space, and I'm going to just type in the coordinate for the begin vertical curve, which is 0, comma, 56, 55. It goes off my screen, but that's okay. And I'm going to go left 100 and down, so negative 5.5. So I'm actually drawing it left, but zoom extends here. So there's the no vertical exaggeration in this example, but simply you could have multiplied, I could have, you know, by 10, that would have been down 55 feet, and all the numbers in your spreadsheet, you could just make another column and multiply those differences by 10. So you would have had to take the difference in the elevation, multiply that by 10, and then add that back to the original elevation to get like a drawing with a times 10, or a 10 times vertical exaggeration. Anyway, there's the first slope, and I want to draw another slope at the end vertical curve, which is going to be at 200 in the x-coordinate. And as the spreadsheet indicated, it was 5,656 feet. And it's going to go to the right 100 and go down 4.5 feet. Back out. So these are my two adjoining slopes with no vertical exaggeration again. And now probably the easiest way to do this is I can just draw the curve with a spline. And if I set the method of the spline to a CV curve, then I could just draw it. So the second point on, just three points, and the second point would be the intersection. So just using some good tracking techniques, that would be the point of intersection, actually, and then end it here. And that'll draw it. However, I neglected to check for, after I check the method to be CV, I can change the degree to 2. Normally, I think the default is 3, So we want to make sure it's 2, so it's a quadratic, and so it'll draw a pure polynomial. What do you call those things? Parabolas. So here we go again. I can draw a parabola across these 2 points. I'm going to track from the left along its extension, or relative polar, 0 degrees, and then I can track this extension. I get it right there. There's both relative polar and extension, and then end it at the end. And then there's supposedly a pure parabola across those 2 slopes. Okay, so I want to check the elevations at the points at every station point. So I'm just going to draw, for construction purposes, I'll just draw a vertical line through each of these and offset them 25 feet. There's 50, 75, 100, 125, 150, 175, and 200, which should be one more. Right at the end of that line, so they intersect. So I'm going to type in p-type. I'm going to put some points down here and make sure there are points that are visible. 5% of the screen's okay for now. And I already know the elevation there because I typed it in. So I'm going to just go to intersection. That's a midpoint, so I've got to make sure I'm there. That's why I don't like that percent option, but we'll change that. And there's the endpoint, so that'll be good. Okay, let's try p-type again. And I'll make this in absolute units, maybe 10 feet. Okay, that's too big. Let's go 4. Good enough. So what I want to do is just select these points. I'll just check their elevations, their y coordinates. And so I could label them with that using a field label. But anyway, just to be quick about it, 56, 56.21, and checking with the spreadsheet that we made, it's 2188. It's good to the fourth decimal place at least. So very accurate drawing the parabola, as well as these numbers do jive extremely well with the spreadsheet. Checking all these numbers. Also, I'd like to add a point at the vertex, so I have those numbers. So one more point here with 110 feet at the vertex, and at 56, 58.025, and there's the vertex, and you can see it's almost spot on. In fact, if I just regenerate, I bet that's going to be even closer. So within thousands of a foot for the vertex. So we have good accuracy with this method, and a pretty looking parabola.